they banish him. Okay? So his God also banishes us.
Okay.
And although he loves us and you didn't question about it.
Okay. I want to say this, that God doesn't want to punish, but he does punish.
Mungu apende kutupuni, lakini kuna mara anapatia punishment.
When we sin, does God punish us first? When we sin, does God punish us first? Or does it move in our heart to change our heart to repent? We find it very often when we sin, God keep moving in our heart so that we start to respond and repent. Now God does punish. If a person continue to sin and reject God, one way he punishes us, when people don't love God, they are separated from God. And they suffer the consequence.
There
will be fighting in the family.
There
will be splitting of churches. The splitting of the churches. Just split up into two or more. And a person's health goes worse and worse. Because they don't get the blessings of God. Let me tell you, there are many Christians who are suffering. Why? Because they don't have a close relationship with God. Then they're separated from God. God wants to bless them. But God cannot bless them. Now for David, when he committed adultery and murder, he was punished heavily by God. And in the New Testament, Ananias and Sapphira, they cheated the church. And they were killed instantly by God. But God doesn't do that all the time. If he does that all the time, no one will be standing here. God uses his love to change people more than punishment. Let me ask you here, are you changed by the punishment of your parents and the teacher? Are you changed by the punishment? Or are you changed by the love of some Christians? Let me ask you, who changed you more, punishment or the love of the people?
I tell you, listen, nini inabadilisha? Ni upendo ama malipizi? Love.
Right. Now, if our children don't obey God and don't obey us,
kama watoto wetu hawatutii ama hawatii Mungu,
instead of spanking us every time, we can tell them, what do you think about what you have done? Does it hurt someone? Does it hurt you? Does it hurt your relationship with
God?
Do you believe your life is precious? God can make your life go higher and higher. Do you want to be blessed by God? So do you want to repent? So this is how I draw people to repent. Not by punishment. But there are times I have to warn people. When they are serious in sins.
shida fulani.
I have to tell them. I have to tell them.
Ninapaswa kuambia.
Are you aware what you are doing can offend God?
Ninawaliza, unajua kwamba yale umefanya imemfanyia Mungu vibaya.
If you lose anything from your body,
kama umepoteza kitu kimoja kwa
or lose anything from your possession,
kama unapoteza kitu fulani kwa mali yako,
are you afraid?
Unaogopa?
Are you willing to repent?
Uko tayari kutubu?
So I'm warning. I can warn people.
Naweza kuwavertir.
Okay?
Yeah.
Yes, nashukuru.
So thank you.
Swali yangu mimi nashukuru nasema kama mtu anaweza piga. Ndio ilikuwa kitesi yangu pale. Sasa ile fimbo ndio niko nauliza. Itakuwa ni kwa upendo wa Mungu wale itakuwa juu ile dhambi ndio ilikuwa.
Yeah. He says that he is thankful for the answer. And the second he wanted to ask if the punishment is done because of sin or because of love. Yeah, to say when God punishes you, it means that He punishes you because of a sin, or He punishes you because you have sinned.
Because of sin,
or because you have sinned. Yes, he said this. Is God, when God punishes, first of all, is because He loves you or because you have sinned?
Okay.
Yeah.
It's both. God punishes us for both reasons, because He loves us, He doesn't want us to perish, and also because of our sins.
Yeah. Anatupinire kwanza kwa sababu tulifanya dhambi zetu, na ya pili anatupinire kwa sababu hapendi sisi tupotee.
But the first thing God does is not to punish.
Lakini kitu cha kwanza iko Mungu atupinire atakuwa atupe malipizi.
The first thing He does is to move us to repentance.
Ani kutupelekea sisi tutubu. Jo ya kwanza.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any more questions?
Kama kuna wengine uliza.
Now, we need to go to more questions and answers.
Yes.